It's okay. This'll be fun. So Falco Ganon. Okay, okay. Yo, how has Kai been improving over the past course here? Have you been paying attention? You guys are good to go, whatever. I can't hear it. Oh yeah, I can hear it. I don't either, dude. This is a tough one, too. Whoa, Yink lost to Tony.
Ready? Go!
Yeah, I suppose. I didn't know this was a chain grab. I know Kai's been labbing. I mean, when I played him for the first time, I think like last year at the Hill, I think he was very fresh. But it looks like he's improved again. Of course, I'm still in the dead zone of sometimes they get out of pools, sometimes they don't. So, what can I say? That was a good call out. I mean, what other? Basically, there's only one way to go with that one. So overhead's the right way.
Fair. Edge guard situation. Phantom.
They're kind of playing on top on the other side of the stage from each other. I'm not sure if. Oh, that was nice. Oh, but he couldn't get the follow up. I'm not sure if Kai Kwon Do has a substantial game plan here beyond the typical Falco things. I don't know if he knows to be aware of like. Ooh, that was a great ledge dash.
Lucky for him, a lot of the kill combos work.
Yeah, so it's pretty much kind of rinse and repeat, the standard procedure for Falco, I guess.
Yeah.
Right there, I think he could have slipped the shine out if he'd done short hop shine into a full hop aerial. I think he might have gotten some.
Okay.
Oh, that was nice
there.
Yeah, that was nice.
And he's gotta be careful here.
Yeah. Yeah, one false move and again, send him skyrocketing off stage.
Gets the grab. I gotta go play match.
Fuck you. And you know, Kai Kwon Do is providing significant shield pressure. I think if he cleans up his punishes, his neutral's great, but I think if he cleans up his punishes right now, he'd be able to take things just a little farther. That was a great, great reaction for Kai Kwon Do. Kai Kwon Do really picking up steam here. Seems like he feels better when he's dead. That's great. Yink in a punish situation, got him on the ropes. But now that things are reversed, I think Ganon's a little too heavy to go for a knock top. Yink form a level 9 kill. A nice short tie that snaps in the ledge, but Yink brings it back, takes a stock. We'll see what happens here. I think Kai Kwon Do grows more confident the longer this goes on, so we'll see what happens. He gets the tech chase. Presence of mind. Oh! when Yink misses a tech to lose the stock in game one. It takes him to battlefield. More open stage that I think allows him to have more avenues of escape from high shield pressure, which I think has been the main thing keeping him, locking him down this game. Gets the chain grab. Oh, misses it. Goes for the tournament winner, save. Kai backs off. I think if he, you know, stayed a little bit towards center stage, he would have been able to keep a momentum going his way, but he drew a little too far. Deep confirmed control to the stage. Missing his punish, where Kai misses his ledge dash as well. Now Yink is in the lead. Big battle over center stage here. Okay. Back and forth. A worthy attempt by Kai, but unfortunately he is not Fox. Yink goes for the hard read, trying to show Mom what's up. And a great movement mix up from Yink to bait him into side beam and take it a stop. Yeah, of course.
What's up?
What's up? Let me update this.
This is game.
This is game two.
Oh, okay.
Yink lost the first game to a misledged deck. Yeah. But Yink's had a pretty good advantage this game. He's been mixing up his movement a lot more. I was saying that I think Kai Kwon Do's strength so far has been his shield pressure on Yink, and Yink's strength has been his punishes, particularly the chain grab, which is taking quite a few stocks.
Yeah, I think I've seen Yink play a lot, and it's a lot of running around neutral, trying to get that first hit,
yeah,
and then making as much of that.
Well, Ganon's weaknesses are in his, is if you stay still too long, you're too big to really keep anyone from coming right at you,
yeah,
save for a couple options. So being able to move properly and quickly is something that's very critical.
Yeah, you gotta make
to allow you to get that open.
You gotta make the slow character fast.
Yeah, exactly.
The only thing he has out of shooting is his jab.
Yeah, exactly.
That was really good.
That was great. Into the I don't know if he wanted the tournament winner, but it worked out in his favor anyway. Link's got great presence of mind, so he made it work.
It's probably meant to be for some air.
Yeah.
Neutral seems to have that. See, that's like the Ganon special. You just gotta roll out.
Yeah, roll out.
That's really all you got.
Roll out, waveland through a platform, and take the center stage back. Kai's not really sure how to deal with Yink standing on the platforms. I think he doesn't want to commit to going in. He's obviously afraid of this happening.
Yes.
But I think, interestingly enough, if he were to play ambiguously enough, I think playing from underneath Ganon ends up being an advantage for him. So I think he actually does have a lot of options. That was a nice punish. To challenge Yink on platforms, but lasers is not the idea.
Yeah, I think what he'd want to do is probably go under him, bait something, and then punish
exactly.
him with like a bear.
Exactly.
His bear is much faster than anything getting. Okay, that just might be a kill.
Oh! Yank heckles himself.
I'm gonna down.
Not enough?
Not a lot.
Oh, yeah.
It's probably not that good, but it's definitely.
Definitely looks fun.
It's definitely like an out of left option that you can use.
Yeah.
Once you're exhausted.
Yeah, you know, actually, I think, now that you mention it, Yink has gotten into a situation where he's picked the reverse up quite a few times. and has failed to hit it every time. It's mostly due to technical. It's because he fails the tech, the execution of it. So, nice power shields from Kai. From Yink, making sure Kai has no effect on him across the stage.
It's hot.
Yeah.
Do you know what his tag means?
Yink?
Yeah.
I think I knew at one point. I have some suspicions.
It's like an area code.
Oh, his tag there. No, it's hexadecimal.
For what?
I don't know. There's two of them he uses. That one and another one.
I think up throw.
Oh. Ooh, we know Yink's going for the spicy stuff. Oh my goodness.
This is game 3 now.
This is game 3, yeah. So Yink's going for spicy stuff on game 3. Perhaps being a little too brave.
Maybe.
But I think he does have a significant percent advantage that, and Kai is being non-interactive enough that I think he has. He's got the space to spare.
I think Yink might need to It's like super safe, especially when you think I think he would have clipped Falco at least once or twice in that whole fire transformation exchange.
Yeah, you don't want to listen to it? I can
no,
turn it off.
It's okay, I'll get used to it.
Okay. Yeah, so far I've encountered some people want to listen to it. Oh, misses the jam.
I would have got that.
The desert palm.
I also
And Yink is, you know, he's just like, look, I'm just gonna stand here.
That was really good.
Yeah, that was sweet. Another one. There you go, got the up air, super safe. And Yink scoops the second game out of it.
It's huge.